NASA's recent selection by Sean Duffy has sparked renewed discussion and raised expectations for SpaceX to demonstrate real progress. However, SpaceX has responded admirably, revealing significant updates that have surprised even those who have been closely following its development. These developments suggest the company is progressing faster and with more planning than anticipated, which could change perceptions of NASA's decision. If SpaceX achieves its goals, what initially seemed like a setback could turn out to be a bold and strategic step toward humanity's next lunar voyage with a fully reusable spacecraft. So, what progress has SpaceX made? What key steps are shaping the future of lunar exploration? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. With 2025 approaching, time is running out. This means there's only about a year left before SpaceX is required to conduct its yet-to-be-done lunar landing demonstration, and less than 2 years until the highly anticipated Artemis 3 mission, where astronauts are expected to land on the moon aboard Starship HLS. This is not only a significant milestone for SpaceX, but also a crucial moment for the United States in its renewed race to return to the moon ahead of China. Given the short time frame, this is precisely the time when the first fully developed Starship HLS prototype will be seen. The world is watching closely, not only to see SpaceX's next steps, but also to gauge America's determination to maintain its leadership in this new phase of lunar exploration. However, SpaceX's progress has come under increasing scrutiny lately. Even NASA, the organization that awarded SpaceX the Artemis HLS contract, has raised concerns about the company's development pace. These concerns have led to NASA's recent controversial decision, which has sparked discussion across the aerospace sector. In response, SpaceX appears committed to demonstrating that its progress is genuine and substantial. Concrete developments have begun to emerge, with new indications clearly reflecting ongoing work on the Starship HLS prototype. A particularly interesting event occurred on the 23rd of this month, when an unusual ring segment was extracted from SpaceX's Star Factory. Observers immediately recognized its distinctive shape. The ring appears to taper slightly toward the top, suggesting it could be a component of the Starship's nose cone. As it was being transported to the Sanchez site, many speculated it was destined for scrap. However, the intrigue grew when observers noticed some oddities on its surface. The ring contained a number of evenly spaced square cuts that appeared very deliberate, as if each had been precisely measured and precisely laser-cut from stainless steel.
This was an atypical, discarded segment. It represented the most unusual ring observed at the Star Factory to date. The accuracy of the cuts posed a crucial inquiry. Why would SpaceX create a ring segment in this manner? For numerous hopeful onlookers, the response was obvious. They thought this was not merely scrap, but rather a component of a unique rough prototype, potentially a mock-up for the Starship HLS itself. The square openings could indicate the windows of the crew area. This hypothesis aligns well with previous 3D visualizations of the rough iterations of Starship, which exhibited several sizable windows intended to provide astronauts with an expansive and awe-inspiring perspective of space and the lunar landscape. If this notion holds, the ring may have been utilized for initial structural assessments within the Star Factory. Perhaps engineers at SpaceX were analyzing how adding several windows would influence the durability and stability of the spacecraft's hull. Supporting this concept, each square opening in the ring seems to have one or two vertical metal supports affixed in place. These supports might have been intended to mimic the presence of window frames or reinforcement during pressure assessments. Such testing is quite common. Organizations like Sierra Space conduct similar evaluations on their inflatable habitat modules to verify that windows can endure the forces associated with pressurization. In the case of SpaceX, such evaluations would be even more crucial because Starship is constructed entirely from stainless steel, a rigid and unyielding material as opposed to a flexible option. Testing window structures would enable SpaceX to ascertain whether the hull distorts, fractures, or becomes weaker after modifications for crew access and visibility. Additionally, there is the chance that glass panels or mock windows were briefly placed in the section to test their performance under simulated thermal and pressure scenarios. However, not everyone subscribes to this hopeful view. Many contend that the ring is simply a discarded segment from a prototype that did not satisfy structural specifications. Critics emphasize emphasize that the cutouts in the rings seem to be arranged haphazardly, while the actual windows for Starship HLS would likely be symmetrically aligned in orderly rows. There are also discrepancies with the known design of Starship HLS. As per leaked blueprints, the crew compartment possesses two primary tiers and thus two distinct rows of windows. In contrast, the enigmatic ring section had openings distributed across multiple uneven layers. Furthermore, the windows on HLS are anticipated to be situated solely on the leeward side of the spacecraft, facing away from the intense heat and stress of re-entry, while the opposite side remains solid to enhance structural integrity. The cutouts on the ring, however, appeared to be present on all sides. In conclusion, the square openings themselves seem rather sizable in comparison to the more compact and functional window designs depicted in Starship images. These elements imply that the ring may not actually be a component of an authentic Starship HLS framework. Nevertheless, in spite of these uncertainties, the finding has revitalized enthusiasm within the Starship community. Whether it's a prototype for testing or a rejected fragment, its distinctive design and timing indicate that progress is being made on something novel, potentially linked to SpaceX's lunar missions. At this time, we must await confirmation from SpaceX. As of now, the company has refrained from issuing any formal announcements regarding the intent of this ring, thus allowing for conjecture and excitement. However, one fact stands out. Every slight shift at Starbase now bears significant importance, as each element could represent a further advance toward humanity's return to the moon's surface. So, what are your opinions? Could this enigmatic ring segment be associated with Starship HLS? Please share your views in the comments below. However, it is impossible to assess SpaceX's readiness for Artemis 3 solely based on one ring piece or a singular puzzling prototype. Genuine assurance should derive from the whole system being developed to facilitate the lunar infrastructure. Additionally, this system relies not just on the Starship HLS, but also on another crucial element, the orbital refueling system. Nonetheless, this system poses one of the most significant technical obstacles SpaceX has ever faced. It requires exact docking, seamless fluid transfer between spacecraft, and an extraordinary level of collaboration among several starships operating in sequence. Such an attempt has never been made before. This is the reason the recent activity involving Ship 39, the inaugural V3 prototype, has sparked such considerable speculation and thrill. Observant watchers pointed out something new in its payload area, two unusual metallic pins positioned just below the payload door. These are noticeably different from anything observed in previous Starship designs, and their function seems evident. They might indeed be the first visible indicators of SpaceX's orbital refueling apparatus. For two starships to connect and exchange propellant in orbit, they require strong mechanical and fluid connections. Those dual pins could serve as attachment points where specialized tubes will link to fuel lines, enabling methane and oxygen to flow between starships. At the ends of these tubes, additional couplings would facilitate the transfer and pressure balancing between the two crafts. The emergence of such hardware on S-39 signifies a notable achievement. It implies that SpaceX is no longer merely contemplating refueling, they are in the process of constructing and testing it. Even if these pins will not be operational in the initial V3 missions, their incorporation is a vital advancement. SpaceX can now assess how these components withstand the rigors of launch, ascent, and re-entry.
Any distortion, vibration, or temperature-related issues identified during these initial flights will provide critical insights that influence important design adjustments before the first actual refueling test is conducted. While previous glimpses, such as the mysterious ring component, have left enthusiasts skeptical about the progress of Starship HLS, concrete progress in this refueling design significantly reduces uncertainty. Indications suggest that SpaceX is effectively preparing the tools and systems that will enable lunar travel. However, it must be acknowledged that refueling will not be immediate. Initial V3 missions will focus on testing a new locking system, structural component enhancements, and ensuring reliability in stage recovery through the use of the Mechazilla arm. These missions will also aim to achieve successful payload deployment to orbit while ensuring both stages can safely return for future use. Based on internal sources, timelines, and community assessments, refueling tests will likely begin around Flight 16 or 17, likely around mid-2026. This timeline gives SpaceX several months to refine the ground support and Starship fleet needed for this large-scale endeavor. However, confidence in the system isn't solely based on the equipment. It also stems from SpaceX management. Both Musk and Shotwell have openly discussed refueling, describing it as far less intimidating than critics have perceived. They likened the process to the automated docking of the Crew Dragon capsule with the International Space Station, which SpaceX has achieved with impressive reliability for years. Musk stated that the connection and refueling protocols are comparable to or simpler than the docking procedures used by Dragon, given that Starship's larger design allows for a more capable system. He also confirmed that SpaceX intends to conduct several refueling missions next year using the V3 model. Simultaneously, other subtle but significant clues have emerged, suggesting the simultaneous ongoing development of Starship HLS. A notable image taken in late 2024 shows a distinctive black and white airspace segment within Star Factory. The unusual color and internal configuration suggests the space may belong to a lunar variant. In previous Starship tests, a corridor-like passageway was visible, resembling the airlock entrance that astronauts will use to board and disembark the spacecraft. The airlock is a crucial subsystem, serving as a gateway between the crew's living quarters and the lunar surface, where astronauts will emerge into the harsh, gray lunar dust. Observing such a module on Starbase suggests that SpaceX engineers are considering more than just in-orbit refueling. They have been enhancing the crew experience and integrating life support systems for lunar missions.